Okay, right. Let's have a little look. Turn the power up. The noise you can hear is my switch mode power supply. It's 0-30, 0-10 amps, but it is a cheapie. It's very cheap, but it seems to be doing a rather nice job of this, and I've got it restricted 22 volts at the minute. And 4.8 amps, to max at 4.8 amps, because the transistor, the TIP35C that I have in this little circuit, can only deal with up to 5 amps, absolute maximum rating of 5 amps. So, but, you know, that doesn't look particularly too bad. It looks quite nice actually. I'm quite chuffed. So I'm just going to turn up the voltage a little bit. Just so it goes to the top. But it's not a case of giving it a full voltage, in actual fact. It's a case of just holding back on the voltage a bit and allowing it to max out on the amperage. There's been a few little tune-up parts that I've done to this. I shortened the cables, I did try putting an extra turn on each of the coils and going onto the flyback, but that just killed the chip, killed it outright, straight away. So I reduced it back down again to 4 turns on each side on the flyback, and I don't think that's too bad. It doesn't hit the top every single time, but still it's nearly there. I'm definitely quite happy with this. You know, my first attempt really putting one of these together. I know that I had it on a piece of bit cardboard type thing, and I changed it and put it onto a traditional breadboard. And I'm going to build the rest of the circuit on there as well. I just wanted to see what it would be like, you know, being set properly on a piece of wood. And it is definitely, with a few little modifications, a much better, definitely a much better, I don't know what you'd call it, a feature, an attraction to look at. I get mesmerised. Sometimes I think I'll put my finger in there just to see what would happen, but I'm not going to, because, well, there's no one else here, and that'd be quite a freaky chair. I don't know why it does that, it's such a change in sound. It's definitely something to do with the voltage. Oh, I don't know what it is, I just... Sometimes I talk and I should shut up. I'm gonna blow it. That didn't make any difference really, so I'm gonna adjust the voltage. That was turning it up to give it a full of 30 volts. And then I'm gonna turn it down a little bit. That's peaking at 21 volts. It seems to be peaking around about 4.2 amps, 4.4 amps. So, anyway, until I get it all sorted out nicely on the board. That'll be the last one of these for the my first attempt at a pretty low power, really, Jacob's ladder. When I get the new chip, can't remember which one it was going to, I'm going to get. Hold on. You want to get the new chip, the 2-in-6341, and it'll allow me to put 10 amps at the base. Unless there's another higher powered chip anybody else out there knows, I'm using the TIP35C. I get to put 5 amps to the base. Do you know of another one that's the same sort of package as this, and I can just, you know, swap them out nice and easy without having to move any more cables around or anything? I have had a look at the other TIPs. I think one goes to 6 amp, but really I wouldn't mind something that goes more like 8 amp or 10 amp, of the same sort of type. Yeah, there's the TIP35C there. See if I could have one, you know, pretty much the same as that, but just more power to the base. That'd be fantastic. So anyway, if you like this sort of thing, give us a thumbs up. Subscribe if you want to see my new videos, the bits and pieces I'm putting up. Share. Yeah, or leave a comment. Fantastic if somebody knows about a better chip you can use. Okay, bye y'all.